I'm very happy to be able to get you here today for a special
Masterclass
presentation
de
for a
Monsieur
conference, a
Maître
masterclass
Yu
by
Suzuki.
the master
Il a
Yu
évidemment
Suzuki.
bercé nos cœurs avec
Of
différentes
course,
productions
he
de jeux vidéo,
was always in
avec des
our
créations
hearts with the
nouvelles,
productions of
toujours à la
video games,
recherche des
creations,
dernières
new
technologies.
creations.
Mais je pense que
Always
le mieux
going
pour le
towards
présenter,
new
c'est de prendre
technologies.
cette
I
petite
think that the
vidéo
best
d'introduction.
thing to present him is to see this introductory video.
Eh ben, je crois qu'on peut voir
Well,
vraiment
I
l'étendue
think we can see
de ce
really
travail
the
sur plus de
length,
25, 30
the
ans
breadth
de carrière.
of this
Alors,
work
évidemment,
over 30 years of a
on a le
career.
plaisir de le
So,
recevoir
of
ici.
course,
Est-ce que
we
vous
are
êtes
able
chaud?
to we
Est-ce
have
que vous êtes
the
prêt?
pleasure of having
Vous
him
êtes
here
sûr?
today. Are you ready?
Je vais
Are
entendre
you
ça plus
sure?
fort.
I want to hear more.
Eh bien, on va l'accueillir, Monsieur
All
Yu
right, let's greet
Suzuki,
him,
s'il vous plaît.
Mr. Yu
Un bel applaudissement.
Suzuki.
Merci, monsieur.
Thank you, sir.
Il est accompagné de
He
Florent
is
Gorge.
accompanied by
Florent qui,
Florent Gorge.
évidemment, est
Florent
un homme très
is
très connu ici
a
dans
very
le monde de
famous
l'univers
man
japonais et qui
in
va
this
tout simplement
Japanese
prendre maintenant
world here.
le lead sur cette
And
présentation.
so he's going to take the lead
Merci,
on this
monsieur.
presentation.
Bonjour. Oui, ah, si, ça y est, c'est bon.
There
Enfin,
we
on est
go.
bien, on est bien, on est bien.
Finally.
Bon, merci à toutes et à tous. Merci d'être venus,
Thank
monsieur,
you all
ce
for
soir.
coming so
Bon, mais
numerous
comme nous
tonight.
a gentiment présenté Idir, on est vraiment très
Like
honorés d'avoir
Idir
Monsieur
told us,
Suzuki
we are so
avec nous.
honored to
On a
have
une
Mr.
heure.
Suzuki
En même temps,
here.
on
We
a
have
sélectionné
one
un petit peu
hour,
bien. On aimerait expliquer
including
tout, évidemment,
translation.
au prix de
We're not going to
Monsieur
talk about
Suzuki. On a
everything,
préparé
so in
de
advance,
l'avance, on y
we're
réfléchit, on
sorry,
calcule le
but
maximum d'anecdotes
we
rigolotes,
prepared
etc.
this
On
to try to
pourra
put as
pas
many
parler,
funny
bien
anecdotes as
sûr,
possible. We
de
won't be able
Yu
to talk about
Suzuki en tant
everything,
qu'anecdote sur
but
sa
of
carrière,
course,
son
you'll have
enfance, son
anecdotes
lien à
about his
Suzuki,
career, his
quelques
childhood,
nouveaux
also
jeux sur
Shenmue,
Shenmue 3.
and a
On va
couple
pas tarder à
novelties on
commencer,
Shenmue
mais tout
3.
de suite
So
d'ailleurs,
we're going to
je vais
start right
sauter
now.
ce qu'elle demande. Et kodomo no koro no hanashi o kikasete kudasai. Et kodomo no koro donna asobi o seten deshou ka? Quand vous étiez petit, en fait, quel genre d'enfant
When you
étiez-vous et
were
quel
a
type
child,
de
what kind of
jeux
a kid were you?
faisiez-vous?
What kind of games did you play?
Kodomo no koro wa Lego te yutte, Lego de kuruma tsukuttari, uchusen tsukuttari, roketto hikouki tsukutte, narubeku okki na mono o tsukuru no ga suki deshita. Ouais, je jouais beaucoup au Lego.
I
J'aimais
played
fabriquer
Lego
des
a lot.
voitures,
I
des
loved to
vaisseaux spatiaux,
build cars,
des choses un petit peu
spaceships,
imposantes. Et j'aimais
things that
fabriquer,
were
voilà,
pretty
des choses qui me
imposing,
ressemblent à
and I
mon
liked
âge.
to build things
あ
that
と、
looked like me, that were in my
田舎
image.
だったから、遊びがあんまりなくて、自分で遊びを作って、土の団子を丸い土で こう丸い団子を作って、ほいでこう落として友達とどっちが先に壊れるかっていう競争してます。
And since I lived really in the middle of nowhere, we had to invent our own games with my friends. We had this game where we would get dirt, we'd make balls out of it, and we would let go at the same height, and whoever's ball lasted the longest won. I was pretty good at that game because I had techniques to make the dirt stronger. I'd go heat it up, I'd go get clay, especially in places where I knew that the dirt was harder. I was very good at that game. But I also think that you were a fan of models. Can you tell us about that passion?
プラモデルも好きだったんですけども、なんか特別な使い方してたんですよね。
そうですね。プラモデルを買ってきても作んないんですよ。
はい。
作らないで、すぐこうジャンクボックスにどんどんどんどん放り投げていたんです。
When I was a child, I would regularly have bought models, boxes with models. I would never build what was in the instruction.
たくさん貯めて、その部品で自分の作りたいものを作っていたんです。
Donc, en réalité, quand j'ouvrais la boîte, je
détachais. So when I opened up the box, I would detach all the pieces, put it in one big box, and then would build things that looked like me. I didn't want to do what people asked me to do. So I imagine it must have surprised your parents.
ダイレクトに車輪につけて最強の車作ったり。
So he realized that he really liked to add things according to his own taste, like pretty powerful motors, and I like to build cars with these models.
そうですね。親は普通の子供はプラモデルを買ってきたら作ってペイントして飾るじゃないですか。で、僕がそういうことしないので怒ってましたね。
Effectivement, mes parents, ils trouvaient ça très bizarre.
My parents thought it was pretty strange because, in their mind, when you bought a box set, you opened up the box, you did exactly what the instructions asked, you painted it, and then you used it to decorate your room, your bedroom. And so they got pretty, they'd get annoyed, they'd get mad. They said, build the model and then put it in your bedroom. So once I built exactly as it was instructed, and then as soon as they saw it, they were happy, I destroyed the whole thing and put it in my box where I had all the pieces. So I think your parents were musicians, they were music teachers. Did it have an influence on you?Yes, my parents were both teachers in a primary school. My mother was also a piano teacher. She tried to teach me how to play piano and forced me to listen to classical music, but I was a pretty rebellious child at the time. I hated listening to piano and classical music. I wanted to do rock and roll.
でラジオから音を流してエレキギターみたいにして弾いてましたね。
And actually, I wanted to play electric guitar, but all I had was a classical guitar. So I created my own electric guitar by putting it through an amp. So your parents didn't want to buy you an electric guitar?
エレキイコール不良のイメージがあったので、親はなんかすごく嫌がったんです。
Non, mes parents, ils étaient totalement contre.
No, my parents were against. At that time in Japan, there was an image, a very negative image of the electric guitar. Electric guitar meant that you were a punk, and I had that's why I had to do it myself. So when you were younger, what job did you want to do?
So
when I was a kid, I already realized that working wasn't great, and I wanted to find a job that would give me as much time as possible for my passions. That was my priority. What kind of job can I find to have as much free time as possible? So when I was a kid, I thought, well, what about not becoming a teacher? Because there's a lot of vacation in summer, in winter. It allowed me to do nothing. It was great. Then I wanted to be a dentist. Because it's an independent job, so you can pick your own vacation. You can take days whenever you want. So I thought, if I'm going to have a job, I may as well have one where I can choose when I can rest. And in the end, I went into Sega and I chose them because they guaranteed 2 days off a week. So these were jobs that had nothing to do with programming.
So I
asked him, why did you choose programmer? And he said, because I lived in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of the countryside, all the names that had a name, all the jobs with a name in English sounded really cool, like illustrator. Through my ear, since I lived in the middle of the countryside, it sounded really good. So I went towards programmer because there was, I was wrong in my mind. I thought pro, you know, I knew that meant professional. And grammar, I thought it sounded like love. So I thought, it must be something like sexy women. So if I become a pro in love, then I should have, you know, it should be pretty cool.
Belle anecdote.
What an anecdote. So you must have been disappointed when you actually became a programmer. So Mr. Suzuki went into Sega and he developed a large number of games that became huge hits like Hangan, like Outrun, Space Run, Afterburner. And when you think about it, when you think about all this, during all these Sega years, there's something in common with it in all these games. There's, you know, like really his style. We can recognize it. And so for you, what is this special Suzuki type?
すごい調べるんです。色々研究して調べます。
Alors peut-être qu'en fait le dénominateur commun à tout ça c'est que
So maybe the common element is just that when I start developing a game I really go very far into research. Not just a little bit. I research as much as possible. So for example, when I wanted to go into a racing game, I started doing research, you know, in-depth research about aerodynamics, how tires worked, what types of tires you used in different races. When I looked into Ferrari, I wanted to know how much the the black horse would raise up. I went really far. So for example, for the game Afterburner, I did a lot of research on aviation, types like planes like Mirage, how many missiles they could carry, how many miles they needed to turn around, their max speed. Anytime I went into a new field for a game, I really became kind of a specialist in that field.
Alors peut-être que c'est ça au final qui
fait maybe that's my special Suzuki touch that people talk about it today. So instead of doing research on what already exists, other games, I would really do research on reality. And as much as possible, I would go in a car and go on the circuit or go on a motorcycle. I would really be able to get the essence of that activity that was a passion and to put it as much as I could into a game.
になりましたけれども、車の大好きな人もいっぱいいると思うんですが、on a, je crois, une petite vidéo,
we have a small video from a developer. We have a surprise, a question by a developer.
Hi, I'm Steve Lysett from Sumo Digital. As you may know, we're big fans of Yu Suzuki's work, not least. Hi, I'm Steve Lysett from Sumo Digital. As you may know, we're big fans of Yu Suzuki's work, not least of Ryozuki Racing and Outrun Cabinet, the Space Harrier Cap, and the Super Hang-On Bike. Within All-Star Racing Transformed. I'd also personally like to thank Yu Suzuki for kickstarting Shenmue 3, which was an idea that kind of floated on the internet a while back. But today, I have a special question. Isn't it time we had a new version of Space Harrier?
Space Harrier, 大好きな人いっぱいいますね。
Et la moitié est bien d'accord hein, pour un Space Harrier.
Ouais, ouais. Donc, 質問ですけれども、Space Harrier、いつかまた新しい作品遊びたい人がいっぱいいると思うんですけれども、何か次 Space Harrier とか可能性ありますでしょうか。Est-ce qu'on a des chances de revoir Space Harrier arriver un jour?
So, do we have a chance of seeing Space Harrier again one day?
やると楽しそうですね。新しいやつは多分。
Yeah, no, I'd really like to. Why not one day make another Space Harrier? And I can't really talk about it, but I have projects here and there, and it would be pretty good to use a game like this. A bit of a teasing. So someone, of course, would love that. Space here, Harrier in VR. So we were talking about Outrun a little bit earlier. We quoted it. So you told several times that you wanted to look at the movie Cannonball and use that as an inspiration, you know, that going from east to west in the States. And in the end, you were looking towards Europe, towards a trip in Europe. Do you have stories from that trip, a big trip that took him throughout Europe?
なんか面白いエピソードとかありますでしょうか。
そうですね、フランスに来た時に、南フランスの方だったと思うんですけど、なんか取材の旅行2週間だったんですけど、やっぱりお腹が減るじゃないですか。
So I came 2 weeks in Europe indeed, and I have one memory. It was in the south of France, and when we travel a lot, we're hungry.
レストランに行ってメニューをくださいって頼むと、なんか料理が出てきちゃうんですよね。でまたどこ行ってもまたメニューをどこ行ってもメニューをくださいって言うと料理が出てきちゃう。
はい。
So I ended up in a restaurant and I asked the waiter, can you bring me a menu? And he didn't bring me a card, he just bring me all the different foods, one after another, and it happened again in different restaurants where they would bring the plates out one at a time and show me everything. So apparently I understood later on that I wasn't really asking menus, since I don't speak French, I would just ask for the daily. So every time they would bring whatever they had as a daily special. In the end, I learned that you should ask for the menu, the card. It was easier to choose your meal.
Donc j'étais très content, j'avais enfin compris comment faire. Donc dans le restaurant suivant, j'ai vu le garçon, je lui ai dit est-ce que
I was really happy. Next time I asked him, and he indeed brought me the card, the menu. I was really happy. I finally got.
Mais le problème c'est que je comprenais rien ce qu'il y avait marqué dessus.
But in the problem was I couldn't understand anything. So I took 4 meals at random. I ended up with 4 soups, and that was my dinner, like an old man eating soup.
So I finally
got the right skill. I'm going to take something from this part of the menu, this part of the menu, this part, and that should work out. So since I didn't speak French, that taught me anyway how to, you know, get around the difficulties and manage. Was it good?
Ouais, au Japon, quand on demande une soupe, c'est toujours un tout petit truc.
So, in Japan, when we ask for a soup, when we ask for something, they bring you just that. It's small. Whereas here, they bring you a full meal.
Ensuite, je sais plus ce qu'on a de doit dire.
On a encore quelques contenus.
Ah bah oui, c'est vrai, c'est ça. On parlait effectivement à l'instant.
So a second ago we were talking about Outrun, and that anecdote came from there, because when we talk about Suzuki and racing games, we also think about virtual racing. Are there any virtual racing fans here?
Yeah.
So there are other fans, not just here, and among those fans there is another special question, but I think he knows him very well.
Yu-san,
it's been a while. This is Suda51 from Grasshopper Manufacturer. Congratulations on the announcements around Shenmue 3. It's coming out very soon. As a player, I'm looking forward to diving into it. My favorite game among all your creations is Virtua Racing. You could even say that it's a game that changed my life. In fact, the first time I met you was during the development of Virtua Racing in the AM2 building. Do you remember? One day we were having dinner together and you told me you had no memory of our first meeting. But to me, it was by meeting you that I wanted to create video games. And here I am, a video game developer. So I have a small question to ask. If you had the possibility of creating a new racing game, what would it look like? F1 or anything else, it doesn't matter. Once upon a time, you opted for Ferrari. Now, would it be Lamborghini? Or since you're in France, would you choose Renault or Peugeot? In any case, what would your racing game look like? There you go. Goodbye.
Message, hein?
Ouais, sympa, ouais. Merci à Monsieur Suda.
Thank you to Mr. Suda.
Ça t'est... 質問になりましたけれども、どんなドライブゲーム、どんなゲームを作るんでしょうか。Quel genre de jeu vous feriez si vous feriez
un... So, what type of game would you make if you did a racing game?
考えるだけでなんかワクワクしますね。
C'est déjà rien que d'y penser en fait, ça me fait
plaisir. Just thinking about it really, you know, brings me joy. I love racing games.
Alors là,
まずサーキットに行って走りたいな。
Déjà, il faudrait que je recommence à faire mes recherches.
Well,
donc j'irai dans les
to start with, I'd have to start researching again to, you know, get a lot of joy from playing around with fast cars. And from there, ideas will probably come.
Le Mans 24が気になっていて、僕一回も見たことがないから、Le Mans 24を見に行きたいな。
Ensuite, ça me permettrait peut-être de me balader un petit peu. J'aimerais bien.
I could maybe, you know, it'd be a good opportunity to go around. I'd love to go to the 24 hours in Le Mans. I've never been able to go, and it's always appealed to me. I'd love to go. No one from Le Mans is here, apparently.
どんなゲームになるんですか？具体的に。
困ったな。
C'est pas une question facile, mais.
Not an easy question.
渋滞 rally とか.
Alors, je ferais peut-être une course, une simulation
I would
de course, mais en
maybe do a racing simulation, but during rush hour, when there's gridlock, you have to use your GPS.
GPS から車のデータを全部持ってきて、それで A 地点から B 地点まで A スタートとゴールで、でそこで。その中でオンラインで、レースをする。
Ce serait une simulation de type.
So it would be a simulation like a rally online by using data received by GPS. So I would get all the GPS data in real time of what's going on on the streets of actual countries. And your goal would be to go from point A to point B as fast as possible with bumper to bumper, and to be able to go as fast as possible to go from those two points.
GPS のデータを使ってるから毎回違う状況になります。ですからルートも人と違うルートを選んで、で誰よりも早く着いた人が勝ちみたいな。
And what's interesting with this concept is that the streets change all the time. It's very unpredictable because it changes all the time. Every race would be different. You'd have to take different roads every time. You'd have to really think and drive in very different situations, depending on the time, depending on the place. Every race would really be different.So it would really be using the concept differently. I've always made racing games with the specificity, the main one of going fast and of being good. This one, the talent, the main talent is not necessarily to be good at racing, at driving. It's to be able to figure out the way, the best way to go from point A to point B.
早くなってしまうんですけれども、les défis, alors les minutes, c'est vrai qu'elles défilent un petit peu vite. Ça va,
so time is running, and we need to keep going. So maybe it's time to go into Shenmue. Maybe.
Ça vous intéresse, Shenmue.
Are you interested in Shenmue?
Bah, je crois que c'est le moment alors.
All right, looks like it's time.
Donc, on a un petit trailer, hein, je crois, à proposer, ouais, pour se remettre dans.
Okay, we have a short trailer to get back into things.
Peggy 16.うまいさんのクンフーが足りているとはわしにはとても思えんが。
ロシ、俺は。
その昔、憲法の修行が禁じられた時代があった。しかし人間とは面白い。お上の目が届かぬ様々な場所で修行を集まれた。その一つがこうした船の上、こうして後のように難件は受け継がれた。
なんだと？
やめろ。 店を脅して金を巻き上げたり昼から酒を飲んで暴れたり町の人たちは怖がるばかり
なんて連中だ
おい待て
俺たちの邪魔をしやがる日本人は
一人で乗り込むとはいい度胸だ
Merci.
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 Thank you. So, the same with Outrun, in its time, you told us a funny story about your trip when you were preparing it. We also heard that you did a lot of research in China. Do you have trips? Do you have anecdotes about your trip in China? China and Hong Kong.
バーチャファイターが結構関係があるのでバーチャファイターの時の取材とかも含めてちょっとなんか喋ってみていいですかね
あ、いい、あ、いや、もう、il demande, c'est des anecdotes que je peux vous raconter qui concernent
So, the anecdotes are also about Virtua Fighter because you know that the development of Shenmue and Virtua Fighter were, you know, intricate, they were done at the same time And so he'll tell us about that period in general. So among the first things that I wanted to know and discover were the techniques, the counterattacks from Kung Fu. If I do this type of attack, how do actual people who do Kung Fu react and counterattack? So he went to a Shaolin temple to find out. And when you go to the Shaolin temple, you realize that there are many, many, many schools of Kung Fu that have different takes on things. So you have different dojos with different types of kung fu. So, when I was in front of a teacher, I would ask, if I attack you like this, so I'd show him slowly, how would you react to that hit? And the thing is, I couldn't see any difference between the way they counterattack. Because I was doing it so slow, and my adversary, my opponent, would just move to the side or move back. And they would ask, why do you go so slowly? Because if you go this slow, we don't even need to avoid you. Go as fast as possible, really go for it. We're specialists, we train every day, you're just an novice. Don't worry, you won't be able to touch us. So just go for it, attack. Otherwise, you'll never see the differences in the different counterattacks.
はい。生徒が集まってきて、なんか日本人が少林寺拳法に挑戦しに来たように見えたんですね、きっと。
Et donc j'ai commencé à y aller franchement, c'est-à-dire aller au
So I started really going for it, going to the absolute the maximum I had. And that's when kids, students of that school started, you know, gathering around us and looking and thinking I had challenged their master.
Ils étaient persuadés que c'était un défi en gros.
They were certain that it was an actual fight between different dojos. Whenever I'd get hit, they were really happy to see that they were the best, they were better than karate, because I was Japanese. But since I was really going for it, they, by sheer reflex, would counterattack, and they wouldn't always stop in time. So I got hit everywhere. Even one of my ribs was broken. And I'm not gonna lie, at the time it really hurt, but now when I think back, it's really a great memory. All those, you know, the everything I had, those were achievements. So
I
suppose you filmed that because it was kind of for a documentary. You needed to document everything to use it in the game later on. Yes, we did record everything. We had brought a camera at the time that could film at high frame rate. At the time it was 100 images per second. That was the speed that we had managed to get. I wanted to film and really decompose every hit. So we would ask the teacher to do the different hits. And we realized that we didn't have the whole hit within those 100 images. So when we saw the teacher doing his hit, we could see that his fist was completely out, but we didn't have the image of the arm being all the way out. So we realized that within a fraction of a second, he had already started bringing back his fist. That's when I started thinking that really those Shaolin monks were incredible. They were really not ordinary, out of the ordinary. So when we talk about Shenmue as well, it's a game that really touched a lot of teachers, all the people who are here. If you're here, I suppose it means that Shenmue impacted you. So what I'd like to know is, in reality, a lot of games came out at that time, but very few managed to impact people as much. Why does this game, even 20 years after, have such an impact? Why does it still touch players as much?
So
when I was much younger, I developed only arcade games. And you know that they're special because within 3 minutes, you need to propose as much as possible. It's a condensed experience. In 3 minutes, you have as many elements as possible to give pleasure to the player.
やったゲームが成功して、それで複数のテーマを持ってるやつは大体失敗しちゃった。
Et c'est vrai que à cette époque, la pratique, c'était surtout
And at that time, really, the way we did it was we needed one game, since we didn't have a lot of time to play, one game with a unique theme, and to get that focus on that theme.
Et à l'époque, c'est vrai que c'était tabou.
And at that time, it was kind of a taboo to say we're going to do one game with different themes, with the things that have nothing to do with one another. So when we concentrate on only one theme, one thing, we really have a lot of time to develop it. But in a game that has a lot of those, all of the different themes are going to be much less developed and much less interesting. That was a taboo at the time.
あの、反対したけど、あの、バーチャファイターも作ったし、ドライブゲームも作ったし、飛行機のゲームも作ったから、あの、いろいろなノウハウが、もあるし、ライブラリーもあるから、それを使えばテーマが複数あっても、なんかできるんじゃないかなと思って、シェンムを始めたんですね。
And a lot of people had told me you shouldn't mix different genres like that. But I trusted in myself. When I was younger, I had developed racing games, Virtua Fighter, so that was a fighting game, a lot of different simulators, even Flight Simulator. I had enough experience, I was specialized enough in all these different themes to do kind of a best of that would really work. So why not make a mix of all these different universes, everything I've learned throughout my career, in just one game, and that became Shenmue. You probably have that in mind, but when I had to develop Shenmue 1, it was very, very hard to develop. I had a lot of trouble with that game. But it was good, wasn't it? So now we're going to talk about Shenmue 3. Are you ready for Shenmue 3?
Ok, on va regarder un petit truc.
All right, let's look at something.
Huh? It was just a fortune. I only said wine was bad for his luck.
So, a couple of visuals. You thought it was a trailer? Not the trailer. A little technical quack, sorry.
Where are you going to go next?
The rest is up to you.
At the time, was it different from the
Peggy 12,
which is going to come out at the end of this year?
Sonomono, Higashi no Totsuku ni yori, umi wo watari te arawareri.
Shenmue 1 de, chapter 2 ga Shenmue 2 de, ano 1:1 de tsukuro to omottetan desu ne.
At the time, when I wrote the script for Shenmue, I'd written 11 chapters, and I'd started with Shenmue 1 as chapter 1, Shenmue 2, chapter 2, and Shenmue 3, chapter 3, etc.
Shenmue 3 was at that pace, I thought I wouldn't be able to live in my life anymore.
Effectivement, vous l'avez remarqué, hein, mais il s'est passé une vingtaine d'années.
But you've realized it. You know, there has been 20 years. 20 years have gone by since Shenmue 2. So if we have to go until Shenmue 11, I'll be dead by. So the script really hasn't changed compared to what I had 20 years ago. I just had to rethink the structure of the third episode to be more efficient and have less episodes in total. And so for you, what's the central specificity of Shenmue 3?
とにかくゆっくりゆったりと遊んでほしいゲームですね。
So for me, Shenmue 3 is a game for which I'd like you to take your time. Take your time playing it. I really integrated an incredible number of possibilities in every aspect of the game. The point of Shenmue 3 is to take your time and discover them all. It's a game that really shows itself as you go along, as you discover new aspects. And for me, I really imagine Shenmue 3 as a trip, as a big voyage, and kind of an initiation. Unlike many current games, we didn't really put a lot of tutorials because we wanted you to have different options to get to where you want to go. The sensation is going to be different if you have to figure it out and find that your way of getting to the destination. So it really is a game. I really want to tell you, it's a game that you need to savor over time. If you take your time, not just race through it, you're really going to appreciate it. It's a game that gives a lot of freedom. So at the time, we're at a time in development with a lot of testers doing play check. And when we watch them play, there are some players that know Shenmue, some who don't, some who like Shenmue, some who don't. And we saw that every player has a very different way of playing the game. And clearly, I felt this thing is that every player expresses their own personality. So for example, just one example on an aspect of the game, greedy people won't play at all in the same way as other people who are more economical and who plan ahead. Some will think, I'm going to get my money in a very hard way by cutting trees. Others will go as fast as possible to get a fishing pole, to get the biggest fish possible, to get money as soon as possible. And then some people will simply go to the casino and think that they're going to earn money or win money more easily. Other people are going to be more physical and they're going to learn every single side of fighting techniques and think that they're going to get money by fighting and by buying the right equipment. And we have a common objective for all the players, but for the moment, in every playtest that we've done with people who played Shenmue 3, I've never seen the same playthrough twice. It really shows the number of different branches that you have to really make this experience unique and make it. I thought that if I had to sum up Shenmue 3 in just one punchline, it's pretty hard to find. The punchline I'd use is Shenmue 3 is a mirror of yourself. Wow, Shenmue 3.
Hi. 楽しいですね。それでですけども、もうそろそろ終わりに参りましたが、なんか最後に皆さんのためにいろいろ用意してくださってると思うんですが、何かありますか？C'est vrai qu'on approche malheureusement de la fin de la conférence.
So unfortunately, we're getting towards the end of. But I think that Mr. Suzuki brought a couple surprises for you.
あとはシェンムーを 96年ぐらいにシェンムーを開発した当時のスケッチと、あとちょっとまあ公開はしてるんですけど、なかなか皆さんの目になんか止まりにくいあのトレーラーみたいなものを持ってきたので、スクリーンショットからちょっとお見せしましょう。
Alors il va y avoir trois choses qu'on va vous
So there are going to be three things that we're going to show in just a moment. First of all, screenshots that we've never shown before. You'll be the first to see them. Then we're going to show you documents that maybe some people have seen. I think we've shown those before. They date from 1995 and 96 when we were developing the first Shenmue. And the third surprise is a short trailer, which is not brand new, but very few people have seen it. We used it in very specific occasions.
Ok, j'arrive. Start. Allons-y.
All right, let's go.
Alors, expliquez-nous.
So, tell us about these. So, this is Chai, an enemy that we had in Shenmue 1. You know him, of course. We see that he's attacking Ryo and his friends. And since you didn't have a lot of news of Nundi, I thought maybe I'll give you some news. So here he is, a very classy visual of Nundi. This is the market that you'll be able to visit in the very first town. And it's the Panda Market. Kind of a cute name.
It's
a village that really exists, and it's the center of activity in this town and in the region. You can see there's going to be an arcade, and there's going to be a lot of activities. You'll be able to exchange some things as well. It really is the hub of activity for this village, and it's got a lot of the charm that you have in China. And so you saw an arcade. You're in a town that's called Chom. I don't know if that's going to be the name in English. So of course, we'll be able to play all of these. I prepared a certain number of games so that you can take, you know, have a lot of pleasure in here with a lot of mini games. I'm not going to reveal too much, but compared to Shenmue 1, In Shenmue 1, you could play old games, but once you were done with that game, it was finished. Here, we went further with the concept, because if you, the better your scores, you'll be able to get better and better stuff. I won't say any more, and it'll incite you to play all these different games that we prepared. So, Florent, Mr. Yu Suzuki, we're going to go into the middle of the 90s and look at the document. So you can see a sketch from the mid-90s. I've always loved Fenwick's, I've got to admit.
どんな量からスタートするか。あの、元々はそのバーチャファイターRPGでアキラがモデルだけど、そのモデルで行くのか、それともちょっとこう優しい感じで行くのか、不良の感じで行くのかを迷ってた時のいろんな
Cette image, hein, ce croquis,
this sketch dates from the time when we were still doing graphical research for the aspect that we wanted for Ryo. At the time, he was supposed to be Akira from Virtua Fighter, and in the end, we decided to give him another identity and personality, and so we were wondering what kind of visual appearance should he have. Should he be pretty cool, pretty weak? So this is part of the graphical research we were doing at the time. So I'm hearing that we don't have a lot more time. We have to go a little bit faster. Like 6 more minutes. This is a young Ryo. So here we can see a little bit of an innocent Ryo. The shonen Ryo. At the time, we wanted Ryo to start when he was really young and have him evolve over time to become more and more badass. So this was one of the first sketches when he was young and innocent. We also wondered, what would he look like if he was more badass, if he was more of a rebel? And now Ryo in the middle of a fight. Ryo just walking around in the middle of Yokosuka, the town. We're starting to see the final Ryo, the one you know. So very clearly you can see, you know, the traits from Akira. Those sketches date back from when we were working on Shenmue as the Virtua Fighter RPG. And this image is important because this is really when we figured out, okay, we have the right Ryo. This is the one we want for the game. This is the final Ryo, and that's the one we used to you know, really make our mind. All right. Well, to conclude maybe this conference, do you have a last message for the couple of hundred people who are here and who came to listen to you? Of course, there was the trailer. It's not very long, so we should watch it before the personal message.
It was just a fortune. I only said wine was bad for his luck. Huh? It was just a fortune. I only said wine was bad for his luck.
Wow. very convincing.
Where are you going to go next?
The rest is up to you.
Well, thank you. Well, again, you know, same question. Do you have a final word? I wanted to thank you all so much, because if we can create this Shenmue 3, it's thanks to the support of fans and of backers. Once again, thank you for your support.
Merci beaucoup.
And then he said thank you in French.
Merci à Yu Suzuki.
A big thank you to Yu Suzuki, a great honor to receive you in Paris for the Japan Expo, just a few months away from the release of Shenmue 3. Thank you for the great questions, great translation, and Shenmue 3 is coming out November 19th, 2019 on PlayStation 4 and PC. There will also be a collector's edition that you can pre-order right away. And once again, Shenmue 3 is a real passion, is years and years of preparation before before we are able to release it.
Thank you.